Hello and welcome to RTC TV. You are watching Rochester Youth League Baseball. Abby Malko, Scott Sager with me today. We are watching the Fulton Cubs and the Tigers as the first batter for the Fulton Cubs gets a single to shallow left field. And that hitter was Noah. Brings up to bat number two hitter, Wyatt.
It was a good first pitch, first hit. Ready to go, play some baseball today.
And you know the beginning of the game, the first batter, the first pitch is most likely going to be a strike, so great job being aggressive on that.
Absolutely. There's a good chance of rain here today at the Rochester Youth League field, so I know the kids are anxious to get the game in. They're off and running.
And as we all know, baseball can be a slower game, so more aggressive play will definitely make this quicker.
Absolutely. Had a pitch inside there.
And the count is 3-0 to the second. And that is a first walk of the game. So that makes it runners on first and second. Brings up batter number three for the Fulton Cubs, Mike. So great first aggressive pitch by the Tigers pitcher and couldn't find the strike zone on the second batter. Bringing up number three hitter, Mike. Ball one inside.
We got two runners on here, Abby. Batter's leading on the count here. Let's see what happens. Second pitch to this batter.
Two runners on and no outs. Fulton Cubs looking good right now.
Nice
line drive to the outfield. It'll pass the left fielder. The runner from second will score easy. The runner from first is rounding third. He's being flagged home, and not even a play at home, but a play at third. The batter goes sliding in and is safe. Although the ball gets away, he stays at third. So number three batter for the Fulton Cubs, Mike, cleared the bases with a triple, and the Fulton Cubs are on the board with two runs. So great hit. I'm seeing great play by the Fulton Cubs. Really good swings and very aggressive in the strike zone.
Absolutely. They're swinging here today.
And still no outs as the Tigers are in the field. Dalton Jackson throwing for the Tigers and Noah Swango, his partner behind the plate.
He's throwing some good hot balls out there, but they're getting their bats around on them already late in the season.
And he does have a really good fastball, but sometimes there's a fastball just good enough speed where teams match up. And this inning so far, the Fulton Cubs seem to be doing that.
Absolutely.
So this is Caleb up to bat for the Fulton Cubs, number four hitter. And he was robbed of his chances to get a lot of RBIs because of the first batter ahead of him, Mike, who cleared the bases with a triple. And ball is thrown behind him. The runner on third base thinks about going, but holds at third. And very nice pitch, just fouled off. That will even the count at two.
Pitcher seemed to relax there, took his time with that pitch.
And I think the biggest thing at this age, and I remember when I was pitching or when I was playing when I was younger, it's just the muscle memory. Every time I would throw a good pitch, my dad would say, remember what that felt like and do that again. So I think that's what they deal with younger age, trying to make consistent plays.
Absolutely. That's going to make the count full here with no outs. Top of the first inning, the Fulton Cubs leading the Rochester Tigers 2-0.
And no outs with a runner in scoring position. This is a big pitch, can determine an out, a hit, or a walk.
And he gets him swinging.
Strike three for the first out of the inning.
Good pitch, in on the hands, good velocity there.
And good swing as well.
Absolutely.
As you can see, the Fulton Cubs coach is talking about keeping your hands inside because the previous batter got jammed on an inside pitch. Try not to make the same mistake twice. This brings up Brock to the plate.
Takes one down the middle as a first pitch strike. Hope you're enjoying today's game on RTC TV. I'm Scott Saker here with Abby Malko.
Another nice pitch down the middle. And now the batter's in a hole, 0-2. And as you said before, could have some chance of rain, but honestly, it's nice with some cloud cover because as humid as it is, we would be sweating pretty badly if the sun was beating down on us.
Yeah, absolutely. These kids have to endure a lot of that summer heat. Pretty decent night with overcast. Good
and
pitch. Way to come back on that.
Two outs for the inning. This brings up Luke to the plate. So after a quick little rally with the first three batters, they sit down the next two. We'll see what the sixth batter of the inning will do for the Fulton Cubs. He's got a runner on third base. You'd hate to leave him stranded.
A little high on that first pitch. Yeah, you know, and they're down 2-0 right now, but the Tigers need to remember that fundamentals are what's going to save them here in this game. The ball did get by the left fielder. He made a decent throw to second base. Second baseman threw it past the third or over the top of the third baseman's head. And, you know, mistakes are going to happen. You just got to relax and make sure that whatever you do next, hitting your cutoff man, et cetera, stays true to the fundamentals. That's going to prevent some runs here.
Exactly. And I was surprised that they didn't try and throw home, surprised in a good way, that they didn't try and throw home because the ball was at second base and the second runner was almost to home plate, and they didn't throw it home because they wouldn't have had a chance, so they tried to get the go-ahead run at third base. Their throw was a little bit high, but really good fundamentals and good coaching to try and get the runner since there was no chance at the runner at home.
Yeah, well, we got 2 outs. We got 3 balls. He's way behind on this batter. He's high. He's kind of all over the place, losing a little bit of control. Let's see if he can calm down. He's got a force at first or second here.
And great job by the batter, Luke. They just had 2 strikeouts, them being the Fulton Cubs. So 2 strikeouts in a row, you don't want to make it a 3rd strikeout. Good job on him being patient and drawing a walk to get another runner on base. This brings Curtis to the plate. He will be the 7th batter for the Fulton Cubs.
Runner 2nd goes, home goes. Let's see if Noah Swango can't get the ball. Ball stuck to the ground, couldn't get it to it. So we've got a runner now scored, and a runner advances from 1st to 3rd. Very aggressive play here by the Fulton Cubs. They're off with a 3-0 lead here at the top of the first inning. 2 outs.
And ball high makes it 2-0.
He's back to that position where he's got the runner on third. He needs to not worry about that runner and focus on this batter.
And if you were watching the runner previous at third base, he was dancing a lot, kind of putting pressure on the catcher. So he was trying to score. If he wasn't going to be hit in, he was going to try on a pass ball, and that he did.
Good pitch there. Got him to chase one a little high. It's going to take the count to 2-1. You can see already that this Fulton Cubs team is well coached. The kids are paying attention down the baselines.
And the count is 3-1 to batter Curtis for the Fulton Cubs. 3 quick runs for the Fulton Cubs this first inning. We will see how the Tigers react after they get their 3rd out and head to the dugout. And that's the 2nd walk in a row. This brings Sam up to the plate for the Fulton Cubs. And always a dangerous position when you have a runner on first and a runner on third, because it's easier for the runner on first to steal since there is a pressuring threat at third base.
They're going to watch as the runner on first advances.
So that makes two runners in scoring position with Curtis. Excuse me, this is Sam up to bat. Curtis is on second, Luke on third. Counts even at one, two outs, two runners in scoring position for the Fulton Cubs, and they have gotten through pretty far down their lineup in just the first inning.
Batter steps out of the box, collects himself again. It's our first left-handed batter of the day.
That is first left-handed batter and pretty far down the lineup as well. What a different game than softball. You usually see lefties early in the lineup in softball games because they're your quicker, speedy players.
Gotcha. You don't see a shift, don't know if they're not adjusting because they're not worried about it or if they're just not acknowledging the left-handed batter.
Yes, I am with you. And as we saw, the batter took a timeout and stepped out of the box. You don't see that very often.
Oh, and he's hit by the pitch.
To load the bases.
Came inside there. Bases are going to be loaded here. Again, we're in the top of the first inning with RTC-TV's coverage of Rochester Youth League Baseball. Tonight we've got the Rochester Youth League Tigers taking on the Fulton Cubs. Again, the top of the first inning, Fulton leading 3-0.
Two outs, been two outs for three batters now. This will bring Josh to the plate. Luke is on third, Curtis on second, and Sam just took one in the back to put himself on first base. So a big hit here could break open the score for the Fulton Cubs in just the first inning. And that's a strike to even the count at one.
He's got to feel good with that strike. Hadn't seen one lately.
Always a confidence booster.
Then he goes outside again. Runner stays down there at third. Noah Swango, the catcher, runs him back, hands the ball to the pitcher, Dalton Jackson.
I have been impressed with as many pass balls as we've seen the few times that we've been at these games. The catchers have been on the hop, and not many runs have scored from pass balls.
Yeah, you get seen some good skills out here. Jackson is still struggling a bit with that control. I think you get down in the inning like this, Abby, you're probably going to, you know, especially even at this young age, overcompensate, try and overthrow the ball. You're going to lose a lot of your control.
Yep, and you just, it's, I mean, all sports are so mental, but especially a slow game like this, you just think, what can I do, what can I do, what can I do, instead of just doing it, and that comes with experience and learning.
He got him to chase one high inside there. That's going to even up the count 2-2 with two outs here in the first inning.
And the batter's on third base, excuse me, the runner's on third base, playing with the catcher a little bit, dancing, but Noah Swango doing a good job of just getting the ball back to the pitcher.
Got a pass ball. He's lost it. No play at the plate. Swango does recover. One more run scored for the Fulton Cubs.
And although that was a pass ball, that was a run already scored because he walked in that run. Josh just walked, moving everybody over a base and scoring teammate Luke.
Thank you for that.
And now Zach will be up at the plate, the second lefty that we have seen this game.
Yeah, I think at this point you need to see Dalton, depending on his teammates a little bit, put something over the plate, put a ball in play, let one of your teammates help you out and get you out of this inning.
I agree. And too, as a pitcher, you know, they hit him pretty solid the first couple at bats, so he's trying to find the balance between the strike zone and not having them crush it. You know, being a pitcher, some days it's the greatest thing in the world, and other
days.
Another
pass ball. Runner scores there.
And that was a very close play.
So that one will be an official pass ball.
Yes. Moving the runners over a base, leaving first base open.
Making some changes here. Going to make a pitching change. We'll give him time to warm up. You're listening to RTC-TV's production of Rochester Youth League Baseball. We'll be back after this.
RTC-TV, Scott Sager, I'm Abby Malko, and we just had a pitching change for the Tigers in the top of the first inning. The score is 5-0, Fulton Cubs in the lead, and batter Josh for Fulton Cubs at the plate. Runners on second and third. First base is open. We have two outs.
Definitely time for a change. You got a cold arm here, though. It's going to take him just a little while to get into his groove as well.
And he even came in the middle of the batter. The count is 3-0. That ball made it 3-0. So very tough position for this little guy. Comes in with two runners on and in the middle of the count. He doesn't even get to start with a fresh count. But good job pitching a strike. The count is now 3-1. All he's got to do is get one out for the Tigers so they can head back to the dugout and get some runs.
He's struggling. That's going to put the runner back at first base. Load the bases again here for the second time today.
And this is the final batter for the Fulton Cubs. They are batting through. They're batting 11 batters, whereas the Fulton Cubs are, when I got their lineup, they only had 8 on the roster, but it looks like they found a 9th player. And that's a nice hit up the middle. That will score one from third base. And score the second runner who was on second base. So that will score Sam from third, Josh from second, Zach is now at second base, and Jesse with a hit up the middle off the shortstop's glove will be at first base.
Well, that's going to rattle this young pitcher already. Hate to see that coming in, walking your first batter, getting hit. It was a nice pitch over the middle of the plate.
And nice swing as well.
Going to be a ball outside.
And you know, just playing this game for many years and watching Lord knows how many games I've watched, it's crazy how when you're on a roll and you've got a rally going, you don't even realize there's two outs. But when you're on the field, all you're thinking is we just got to get one more out, and sometimes that feat seems impossible.
Going to be a throw to third base. Good backup there by the shortstop. Keeps the runner at third after he steals.
Runners on the corner since Jesse on first base did not advance. But just the momentum swings in sports alone can boggle my mind at times as far as just who's doing well and how you feel when you're doing well and how quickly it can change. Like last weekend when we came to the Tigers-Orioles game and the score was a lot to nothing, and with a couple hits it was tied and the Orioles ended up coming back to win.
Pitch just missed the outside corner. That's going to walk the bases loaded again.
So, bases loaded, still two outs, and Wyatt is up to bat for the Fulton Cubs.
Yeah, as a coach, it's got to be tough. We know this is a good team. We saw them play the other night. I know they're missing a couple players tonight. So they look over at their dugout. It looks like they've got just enough to field a team here, unless one of the coaches wants to suit up, but
they're on their cleats.
Yeah, as a coach, you know, what do? You got your young players, they're struggling out there, you're rooting for them, try to make a pitching change, you know, but as in all sports, in the end, it's up to that individual to calm themselves down and find their own groove.
Right, and comes with experience and learning, and everybody's different as far as, you know, there's some players that I know they love to be screamed at to get them motivated, and there's others where if you scream at them, they'll shut down, you know, so it's just every player's different, and as you learn the game and you realize how you react better, that's just how you get better with experience.
Absolutely. But I still see some smiles out there. Everybody seems to be having fun. It's a rough first inning.
But if you think about this, last week when we were here at the Orioles-Tigers game, this was the Tigers, the first inning, up by 5 runs real quick. So they know what it's like to be on the other end, and they can come back just as easily as the Orioles did last weekend.
Umpire giving him the outside corner 2 times in a row there. That evens up the count 2-2. Again, with 2 outs here. You're watching Rochester Youth League Baseball on RTC TV. I'm Scott Seger with Abby Malco. Top of the first inning still. That ball goes over the head of the batter. That's going to be...
That will walk in the...
Ball 4.
8th run.
Base is still loaded there. We've got player number 8 coming up. That's Mike. How you doing on that scoreboard over there, Abby?
I'm working on it.
Yeah, scorebook, I should say.
Yeah, I missed a couple things. I'll figure it out.
There's a lot of action here.
There is. I figured it out. We're all good now. I know that the bases are loaded, and we've got 2 outs, and there's 8 runs.
Coach Kelly used to tell us in football and also in U.S. government, keep up or take notes.
That is a good motto. I'm definitely a note keeper myself, so I'm working on it.
Okay. We'll count on you to keep those stats for us.
Well, here's the thing. I'm the scoreboard keeper and the score bookkeeper, and you know, I've been to enough softball games where I look up and the scoreboard's wrong, and I'm not very happy with the scoreboard keeper, and that's me right now. So I'm sure there's a couple people frustrated.
Well,
but
there's a line at the door. I've heard some rantings from the clown.
I'm working on it. I'm new here.
We'll keep them at bay.
I'm usually on the field.
Runner thought he had walked there. Not quite to that point in his count. It's going to be ball three, though. He can sit back and relax. Pitcher trying to regroup.
And this
is across the plate.
Mike up to bat. We didn't mention that before.
Nice. Nice play by the short.
Nice play by the
shortstop.
And that will get the Tigers out of the inning. That was the third batter for the Fulton Cubs, batting their second time around the top of the first inning. You're watching Rochester Youth League Baseball on RTC TV.
And we're ready to get started here again. You're with Scott Sager and Abby Malco here at Rochester Youth League Field. We've got the Fulton Cubs taking on the Rochester Tigers.
That sounds weird, Rochester Tigers.
It does a little bit, but Rochester Youth League Tigers. Does that
right.
ring a little better?
Yes, yes.
And tough first inning for Rochester. Missing some players here tonight, some of their key players, in fact. They've got a short squad, just enough to field the or to take the field. Got our first batter up, Abby. Who we got?
This is Dunwoody.
Dunwoody's up. He looks at a first pass ball outside in the dirt. I should mention we're 25 minutes into the broadcast as we start the bottom half of the first inning.
That doesn't happen very often.
No, a little bit of some pitching difficulties here, but I think they've worked through them, and we're looking for some bats to start.
And we have Noah behind the plate for the Fulton Cubs, and Caleb will be on the mound. We seem to have a technical equipment difficulty. The catcher's helmet's a little loose. That's something you don't really want to be loose if you're the catcher. So we will see if the Fulton Cubs pitcher can take care of business and have a quick inning, or if the inning will be strung out like the first half with the Tigers. But right now there is one ball and no strikes. The catcher has got his helmet back on and they are ready to roll. And strike one evens the count at ones. Nobody on base for the leadoff batter for the Tigers is Dunwoody.
Just missed outside with that pitch. His first strike on the pitch before was one of the better pitches we've actually seen today.
Yes, I agree. That makes the count 3-1. And I wonder, we need a baseball expert here with us, but I wonder if there's a time limit rule for the pitchers. I know in softball, you have 10 seconds to get it back from the catcher. Once you're on the mound, 10 seconds to throw it. So that's supposed to speed up the game a little bit. I'm not sure what the rules are in baseball.
I'm not sure either. That was strike two on the batter. That's a good point. Let's just hope that they keep it quick.
Yes, I agree. Fouls off to stay alive in a full count. And baseball is such a slower game than softball anyway, I think, too. A bigger field, and just in general, it's a slower game. So I would just wonder the rules in Little League versus not. And that will be the second foul ball. A very good battle by the first batter for the Tigers, Dunwoody. That's always the motto for a batter. If you've got two strikes on you, you're supposed to foul off the nasty pitches until you get one you're capable of hitting. The problem is when you try and foul it off and it goes fair, that's not very good. Once again, another foul ball. And fouling off all these pitches too just makes the pitcher throw even more. and they're more liable to A, make a mistake and throw a good pitch to you, or B, throw one way off the plate and you can walk. So very good leadoff batter for the Tigers right here. And good swing, good pitch, but one out for the Tigers. Batter number two is Hibner to the plate.
Takes first ball low.
And the center fielder for the Fulton Cubs playing significantly deeper than the Tiger center fielder. Maybe he's better coming in on balls than going back.
He's got some speed. He's confident, young man.
I think so. Nice hit back to the pitcher, and that will be out number two. Good piece of hitting, just missed it because he topped it a little bit, but good job by the fielder, or by the pitcher, fielding it. You always like to see a pitcher that can field the mound, field their circle. That helps out any team. So two outs here, bringing up the number three batter to the plate, Yarber. Good eye on ball one. Probably looks even lower to him since he is significantly taller than the rest of the people around him at
his age. Pitchers love him. They love the strike zone.
Absolutely. I'm sure he loves the length of his arms when he does get a hold of one.
Well, we've seen him. He's a good hitter. We've seen him earlier this season.
Very handy at first base as well.
Absolutely.
Good target for the fielders.
Good all-around kid, good all-around player.
And, you know, height, something you can't coach ever, especially when you have taller kids at this age, it's very helpful.
I stretch my kids out, Abby. I hang
Do
them
you?
From the doorway.
You know, whatever works.
Put some weights on their feet.
Every parent has a philosophy. And
absolutely. That's my retirement plan there.
Yes, that is a very good idea. I hope others will catch on if they're listening to this. Ball high evens the count at two. We are two outs into the inning, have not had a runner on base so far. Number three hitter for the Tigers. Ball outside, good eye. Broke a little bit late, but it was with two strikes. It is a pitch you might want to protect on. Good job by Yarber, not going fishing for it. That will make this full count. See what he can do with this pitch here. Way outside.
Outside on him, Yarber looking back.
He will head to first base, making that the first runner of the inning. Number four batter, Dalton Jackson will come to the plate. He was the starting pitcher for the Tigers.
See if Yarber's going to look to steal on a pass ball.
Very nice hit, just a bit foul.
Yep, just a little late on that. He got around well, put some power behind it, just a little late. As we remember from Todd Beeler when he was here, talked about the fact that at this level, players aren't allowed to lead off the base.
Right.
They have to wait until the ball does cross the plate, but they are able to steal on pass balls.
There were many rules that he informed me of that I probably should have written down because I was not aware of them, but we'll just have to hope he comes back and joins us next time so he can refresh our memories.
Absolutely.
I know leading off was one of them. There's no drop third strike rule. If you strike out whether it's a pass ball or not.
And that was one that always confused me as a player.
The drop third strike?
Yeah, I never knew when to do it. Or,
well, and here's my thing with a drop third strike. And just to interrupt for a second, Yarber takes second base on a bobbled ball. But what always makes me upset is I just struck out. Like, I'm very mad at myself. I am not about to go run to first base. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not a good thing, but I want to go pout back in the dugout. I don't want to run to first base. So That's where I got in trouble.
What do we got there?
And that was strike
three. That was strike
three. So that will end the inning for the Tigers. They will head back out to the field, grab their mitts. You've been watching Rochester Youth League Baseball.
Hold on.
Oh, what happened?
There's confusion on the field. We're all looking to see what's happening here.
Oh.
They're all coming back. We're going to play some more baseball
here
in this inning.
We were just kidding.
What's the count?
One.
Okay, thank
is
you.
Is that two and two that he was holding up there? Does anyone know where the batter went? There he is.
He was in the dugout putting on his glove. He's back.
Okay.
Ready to play some ball.
He's back. He was just messing with us.
He counts one and two there.
Two outs. Yarber on second base. Jackson at the plate.
And that'll do it.
And that is not. Now we're being serious. That was the third out. And now the Tigers will head to the dugout to grab their mitts. Watching Rochester Youth League Baseball on RTC TV.
And we're back here starting the second inning with Rochester Youth League Baseball on RTC TV. Pitching change for the Tigers. Dunwoody now pitching. Faces his first batter, number 11, that's Caleb for Fulton. I'm joined here with Abby Malco.
Hello.
She was busy eating some ice cream right there and couldn't talk.
No, someone muted me.
We're going to tell your coach at Indiana State that you're blowing your workouts.
Not eating, or by eating ice cream?
By eating ice cream.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, Dunwoody has yet to settle down there. He's behind on the count, 3-0.
Number 4 hitter for the Fulton Cubs. He struck out his first time up to bat. We'll see what he can do with this one. And draw a walk, it will be.
Going to put a runner on first here with no outs, top of the second inning. Fulton came out strong in that first inning.
Eight runs.
Couple of walked full, bases loaded. Couple of hits in there, couple of bobbles. It's what you expect at this age level, I think. A learning experience for all.
And swing and a miss on a high pitch. Goes for strike one. This is number 7, Brock, up to bat. Very nice pitch on the outside corner, strike two.
Absolutely.
Let's Brock see if way down in the count.
See if Dunwoody can continue that. Got a couple of strikes on him.
And three in a row.
Finding his groove there. That's a good strikeout by Andrew Dunwoody.
One out for the Tigers. This brings up number 2, Luke, to the plate. If I was a better scorebook keeper, I'd let you know what he did his first at bat, but I do know that he scored.
Well, I had an old coach, Abby, who used to say,
oh boy,
keep up or take notes.
Yep, I'm working on it. Nice pitch, nice hit, and great play by starting pitcher Dalton Jackson. That will make it two outs, but that high chopper could have easily. Those high choppers are dangerous because there's so much topspin on them. They can chop high, and then the next bounce will go in between your legs if you don't play them correctly. So great job by first baseman getting a big out. Excuse me, that was much needed. And if you look at him, he's pretty far off the line right now, so good range on that last batter.
He was playing a little closer because he had the runner there, but he did nice play all the way around. As Dunwoody settles in for another strike, this time on batter number 6.
Curtis,
thank you, Abby. Can you tell us what Curtis did last time?
I don't know what Curtis did, but I do know that he scored.
Got a pass ball there. Noah Swanger going to look at the runner standing up into third base. Again, two outs here. Top of the second inning. Count is 1-1.
Make that 2-1 on an outside pitch. And I know I'm not the best scorebook keeper, but if it surprises you, this is the first time I've ever kept the book. Before I worked for here, I'd never kept a book in my life.
Well, we know it was an athletic scholarship to Indiana State and not an academic one, Abby. So.
Hey, they don't test you on your scorebook keeping skills. Thank goodness for that.
No, we appreciate all your efforts this season, especially keeping the book, calling the plays here with the kids.
Do you think since I keep the scoreboard, too, they'll give me a free slushie downstairs?
They might. If you need a slushie, I'm sure we can find one for you.
Okay. And nice pitch. Great showing
Absolutely.
By Andrew Dunwoody. Strike 3 and third out of the inning bring us to the bottom of the second inning. Scott Sager with me. I'm Abby Malco. You've been watching Rochester Youth League Baseball on RTC TV. Welcome back to Rochester Youth League Baseball on RTC TV. Abby Malko here with me, Scott Sager. Bottom of the second inning, Rensberger for the Tigers is up to bat, and he has one strike on him. Make that two strikes after a big hack and a foul ball.
He's up there slugging. That pitch was definitely high, could have let that pass.
And I think just watching some of the pitches that the kids have swung at today, I think they like the higher pitches. You see all the home run hitters hitting high pitches. So that's part of their...
Just missed the plate there, a little low, right across the plate, just below the knees there. One ball, two strikes.
Nobody on, nobody out.
Gets away a little bit.
Evens the count at two. And big swing and a miss. Good swing by Rensberger. That will be the first out of the inning for the Tigers.
It's a good, solid strikeout for Fulton there.
And bringing up to the plate, number 14, and catching, Noah Swango.
Check swing foul for Noah Swango. Coach Noah in football a few years back when I was coaching some youth league. Good kid, strong kid, listens well, just an all-around good athlete. Looks like he's developing into quite the catcher and quite the baseball player.
Yes, very good catching skills tonight.
Caught the outside corner there. It's going to make the count one and two.
And shout out to your son because I did get my slushy.
You did get the slushy.
Blue and red mix.
Excellent. Good pitch on the outside corner of the plate. Takes down Noah Swango swinging. That's going to be two outs on the Tigers here in the bottom of the second inning. Scores 8-0.
Pretty quick inning so far with two outs and two strikeouts. Not many balls being thrown, not many balls being hit so far.
Well, it takes hits to get runners.
Exactly right.
Or walks.
That's true. Anything, really.
Or a beam pitch.
Yes, which we've seen all of tonight so far.
That's what we try and do here with RTC TV. We bring you everything, all the action, all the time. We're here tonight at Rochester Youth League Baseball. Got a late start on the season in our productions this year as we revamped our new RTC TV. Hopefully we'll catch a lot more action as we get into next summer, but we've enjoyed our time here thus far this year.
And ball on the inside part of the plate. Could have been a strike, especially with two strikes, but it evens the count at two. Number 15, Schaefer at the plate for the Tigers. Ball outside, makes the count full.
Ball high, that's going to put the runner on base.
Very good eye, I thought it could have been called for a strike. Sometimes you never know with umpires, good or bad.
Well, Schaefer, he's a little spark plug. Not the tallest kid in the world, but big in stature. He's one of the hardest working athletes out here, always has been, no matter what sport he's in. Ball comes inside, nice job by the catcher to stop that one. But Schaefer able to get by on that pass ball, or excuse me, on that fourth ball of the series. He's on first base now, and I know he wants to be on second. Ooh, that one gets behind the batter.
And on second, he will go.
And Jordan Schaefer in, standing up on second base. I'll have to fill in for Abby as she's got a brain freeze. She'll be back with us in a moment.
Is that really not the worst feeling, though, a brain freeze?
It is. It is. There's no way to get rid of it.
I know. Somebody said if you ask a math question, it's supposed to work. I don't know. My sister asked me a math question. I can't do mental math.
I think that's a different show. I think that's the Fulton County show where we need some investigative reporting on that one. Stay tuned for that in future episodes of the Fulton County show right here on RTC TV.
And that strike evens the count at two.
Well, we're talking here about productions, Abby. I think maybe you should try that spoonful of cinnamon trick too and see if we can pull that one off for our viewers.
Can't trick me on that one.
Nice pitch down the middle. Struck him out. That's going to take us to the top of the third inning. I'm Scott Sager with Abby Malco. You're watching RTC TV. And we're back here in the top of the third inning. Fulton Cubs visiting the Rochester Youth League Diamond.
Up to bat for the Fulton Cubs is number five, Sam. One strike on his second at bat. Andrew Dunwoody back on the mound after a pretty successful inning, last inning for the Tigers. Ball two in the similar place, up by Sam's ear.
There he goes, settling down a little bit, put that one right across the plate. Sam sat back and watched it as he's head on the count. Now it's evened up, 2-2. See what Dunwoody can bring him. Gets him on the swing. Nice job by Dunwoody settling in there.
And what I've seen from Dunwoody so far is once he gets a strike, he seems to be pretty consistent and consecutive with his strikes once he does find the zone. This is number nine, Josh to the plate.
Found the zone right away on Josh. Get to head on him 1-0. 0-1.
Yes.
Whoa, just a bit outside.
I've always wanted to say that. I need my own baseball catchphrases.
You do.
But hey, if you're not, you know, sometimes they call that wildly effective. Because if the batter is scared of you because the ball's going all over the place, maybe they don't know when a strike's coming in.
Absolutely. It's that scene in Bull Durham where he talked about, you know, kept hitting the bull. Catcher walked up to the batter and he said, "I don't know where it's going. I really don't."
Exactly.
Not going to dig in too deep there on that, are you?
Nope.
But at this league, I honestly think that half the time we don't know.
Right.
And that one skips across the plate.
Makes it count 3-1. But, hey, like the very first game we filmed when it came flying at the camera, made for some of the best footage we've ever had.
Absolutely. Good footage is what we're all about here at RTC TV.
Good footage.
Good slushies.
Yes. Good slushies is my favorite part. And ball high makes that ball four for the first runner of the inning.
He threw the bat over to the dugout, and it rolled out into right field, so they're bringing that back.
That'll take us a second.
And the umpire takes a moment to clean off the plate. We're ready to go here. One out.
This is why baseball and softball can be so slow. This brings up number three, left-handed batter Zach to the plate. Big swing, but a miss for strike one.
Something American about it, though, Abby.
I think
nice
so.
Nice and slow, summer day. Smell of the fresh-cut grass.
Yes. There's something about the spring season after winter season that baseball and softball have.
Gearing up for summer solstice here in a few days.
Yes.
So.
Which is always good, but that means summer's getting by that much faster, and no one likes that.
Well, we're lucky we didn't have a hit there to the second baseman. He's messing around, dropped his glove before the ball was pitched there.
Unfortunate. So. Hey, I'm just glad we haven't seen any sandcastles or rock piles during this game. I think that's the younger.
That's a little younger.
That's the younger, but hey.
Pass ball.
There are days, don't get me wrong, there are days when I would rather be making a sandcastle on the field.
I think I saw that on YouTube. It was the ISU softball team all making sandcastles out in right field.
The blooper reel.
It's your full ride scholarship. State-funded school right there. We got a runner on second base.
And I thought that
I'd tell you what the count was, but Abby's disagreeing with the umpire here. Oh, it's a full-blown fight. No, just kidding. County is 1-2.
We think. And, okay, it was 3-2.
Not even close to 1-2.
Hey, I knew there were two strikes. Either way, Zach walked to first base.
Any complaints about tonight's broadcast can be sent to abigail.malco@rtc1.com.
Oh, that's dangerous. Don't give him my email. There, strike one. One out. Runner on first and second for the Fulton Cubs. I know that much. And this is Jesse, the second left-handed batter, up to the plate.
Oh, now here's an interesting rule. If the ball hits the ground,
yes,
then skips up and hits the player.
It's dead ball. He's heading to first.
Really? Still a hit by a pitch, huh?
Yep. Well, normally, but there
yep,
seems
they
to
do
be
advance.
A bit of confusion.
They
All right.
do advance. Okay.
So as a pitcher, there's probably nothing more aggravating than, you know, throwing a changeup into the dirt, rolling up the shoelace of the batter, which there has been a new rule in softball that if you are in the batter's box and the ball comes at you, you don't have to move. So before the rule was, you know, if the ball came at you and you didn't attempt to move, then it didn't count. But now if you're in the batter's box and the ball comes at you, you do not have to move. But
wow.
If your hands are out of the box over the plate and you get hit, it counts as a strike. I've seen that happen to a couple girls, and that's not a very fun call.
Well, now I know why the coach is always telling you to lean into the pitch.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
There we go.
And
nice
good
play.
Hit
third
by
base.
Noah. Great heads-up play by Yarber at third base for the Tigers to field it and step on third. Sometimes a long throw over from third base. But great job getting the second out.
Yeah, caught the runner sleeping over there at second. Wouldn't have had much of a chance anyways, but he was still on the bag at second when the play was made at third. Wasn't aware he needed to be running. So keep your head in the game. A little high there by Dunwoody. Trying to find that groove again. Had a great outing on his first inning. Caught the outside corner of the plate with that one.
An umpire giving the outside corner this game, and I don't think anybody would complain as long as it's consistent, and he has been on the outside corner pitch.
Just a bit outside.
This is number one, number two batter for the Fulton Cubs, Wyatt.
Ball gets away. Runner doesn't advance.
Makes a count 3-1.
Got to pick up those coaches when you're on second base. Got to be looking down that third base coach, see what he's telling you to do. Easily advanced right there. Could have, I should say.
Yes. Nice pitch, nice hit. Bobble, but at second base. Gets the play at first.
Got the play at first. That's going to do it for the third inning here.
You're watching Rochester Youth League Baseball on RTC TV.
Yeah. And we're back here at Rochester Youth League Field. Scott Seger, Abby Malco, watching the Fulton Cubs take on the Rochester Youth League Tigers.
Score is 9-0 in the bottom of the third inning. Up to bat for the Tigers is leadoff batter. Excuse me. Not the leadoff batter, an added batter. Number 9.
We'll call him the Phantom.
Yes, we are not sure of his name, but he was added after I received the lineup.
Late arrival to tonight's lineup. We'll try and get one of our crack staffers down there to find out the name of that young man.
Yes.
In the meantime, we've got strike one on the foul ball there. I'll help Abby keep score as she's going through sugar convulsions right now. We'll talk about that later. Nice fundamental play by the shortstop.
One out for the Fulton Cubs.
So as we talked about in earlier innings, Abby has a fondness for the slushy, which started out as red and blue.
And now it's purple.
And now is some amalgamate of purple and maybe a little, I don't know what in there, maybe a little red.
Yeah.
And she topped that off with some M&Ms, specifically blue M&Ms.
I don't want to see the color of my teeth right now.
No, we're not going to watch that. But she's twitching every now and again. So if we get a little out of hand with tonight's broadcast, there's a reason.
Strike now, number one on Dunwoody.
I kid, Abby. She is a good sport. We're out here, RTC-TV, Rochester Youth League Baseball, having some fun this summer. Good pitch,
nice.
Good swing.
Whack, I hope that did not hit the bug, which is parked over yonder. I
think that hit the Abby bug.
I would be very upset.
Find a baseball in the front seat.
Rob Malko would be even more upset.
Yeah, well, Rob Malko, known for his calm temper and demeanor, as he as a coach of Rochester High School Athletics for many years.
Yes.
He's taking some good cuts down there.
And Dunwoody was, although struck out in his first at-bat, he had four foul balls in a full count. So he is definitely getting his best swings off and trying to make the pitcher throw his best pitch.
We didn't talk about it, Abby, but I think we did have a pitching change for Fulton.
Yes, we did. Brock is now pitching for Fulton. Okay. And Noah's still behind the plate.
Gotcha. That wouldn't be Noah. That would be Noah would be on the other team, dear.
No, there are two Noahs.
Oh.
But... Actually, you are
right. We have two Noahs catching?
Yes, both Noahs are catching.
That's an incredible coincidence.
I think so, too.
That sounds like another show.
Yes.
Most popular boys' names in youth sports.
If they're both in the same position. But actually, I'd like to say they're both catching, but they switched. Caleb was pitching. Now Caleb is catching. Not sure where Noah's at, but Brock is pitching.
Noah's on the arc.
Yes.
Speaking of Noah, a great flick this summer. Russell Crowe.
Are you being serious?
Yeah, called Noah.
I did not know that.
Yeah, I don't think that Christian groups really enjoyed the movie that much. Is for some reason he had to fight off a bunch of people before he had to fight or before he had to endure the wrath of God through the water. So, I think they took some creative license with that.
Nice hit to the shortstop, fielded cleanly and just in time for out number three.
And again, an incredible fundamental play by the shortstop. Put your strength there. That's going to do it for the third inning. I'm Scott Seger with Abby Malko. Abby, calm down.
Just getting my slushy.
We'll be back to start the fourth inning. And we're back here to start out the fourth inning. Abby Malko, I'm Scott Seger.
Up to bat for the Fulton Cubs is number 8 and number 4 power hitter, Mike.
So strange, only putting first names. We're going to have to
push
these coaches to get us last names on some of these players.
Well, I didn't get numbers, positions, or last names.
We'll work with them here.
But, I mean, I feel like I'm talking to kids like we're buddies. Like, hey, this is
Mike. Hey, my buddy Mike.
You know?
Yeah, Mike's doing a nice job.
That was ball number 2. Ball high is ball number 3 for the leadoff batter of the fourth inning. Make that top of the fourth inning. Mike is 1-for-1 in his at-bat so far. Excuse me, 1-for-2. And make that a walk for Mike. This brings up Caleb to the plate. Caleb was pitching. Now is catching and currently at the plate. Nice hit back to the pitcher. Could turn a double play. He looks for second, but is pulled off the bag. So there's no outs, but good attempt on the play for the leadoff runner. Up to bat is number 7 for the Fulton Cubs, Brock. And he wanted that pitch. Not enough of a check swing to count it as a strike, and the count is 1-0.
How it gets away from him. You got both runners advancing. They're going to be standing. Noah Wisely holds on to it, doesn't throw it down third baseline.
So the count's 2-0. There are no outs, and the Fulton Cubs could be dangerous with no outs and two runners in scoring position with the meat of their lineup at the plate.
Outside again. Gets away from Noah. He's able to get it, get back to the plate before anyone comes across.
But like we said, watching Andrew Dunwoody this game, once he finds a strike zone, he doesn't usually lose it again. So it's just a matter of finding that first strike and sticking with it. And big chopper up the middle, past the pitcher, past the shortstop. That will score one easily, and the second run walks across the plate. So a very high chopper, unfortunate play as it bounces off the mound over the pitcher's head, and the shortstop was just inches under it from snagging it.
There's a nice shot straight up the middle, past the pitcher, past the shortstop, past the second baseman. I think my mom jumped in there and tried to stop it. Made it all the way out the outfield. What was that, two runs that scored off of that?
Two runs scored, like I said. No outs, two runners in scoring position. That's a dangerous place if you're on defense in that position. That puts Brock on first base and brings up number two, Luke, to the plate with two runs in this inning.
It's going to be ball two on the batter, Brock. Runner on first base.
Nice line drive through the hole to the right fielder. If he can stop it, that will be important.
The perfect gapper. The potential rundown here. The runner going to third. See if we can get it.
Nice.
He got him
throw.
Out of there.
And that is why he is at shortstop position, because that kid has a cannon, which was easily thrown the runner out at third. Now, he would not have been thrown out if he wouldn't have hesitated. Once the ball got past the right fielder, you thought he would take off, but he hesitated, went to third a little late, and the shortstop for the Tigers gunned him out.
Good play all the way around. Going to clear the count.
This puts number six, Curtis, at the plate.
Curtis looks at strike one. Dunwoody finding that strike zone again. Thank you for joining us tonight. RTC TV out at Rochester Youth League Field. I can't compliment him enough. Noah Swango's just done an incredible job. These pitchers are having a tough time finding their groove. Noah's able to keep the ball in front of him. If it does get too far outside, or quite frankly too far inside, we've seen some go behind the batters.
Right.
He's able to quickly recognize where it is and get the ball back in play.
Yes, they say if you're a catcher, to be a wall behind the plate, and if he hasn't been a wall, he's been fast enough to get the ones that do get past him.
A little high there. It's going to be ball three. Take the count to 3-1 with one out here in the fourth inning.
And big out by the Tigers, getting the runner at third base a few plays ago. Very good throw by the shortstop.
And you look for that. You look for that one or two good plays at this age to keep you motivated, keep you going. Again, it's the fundamentals that carry us through, all the way through the high school.
Yep.
Into the college level.
And just good that they can learn them at this age and have so much experience already.
Going to be ball one on the new batter.
And although the last batter, Curtis, walked, not necessarily a terrible thing because there was an odd runner on second base, so there's not a force out, but walking the batter did make a force out. So if there happens to be a play on the left-hand side, a quick flip to third base gets the leadoff runner. But up to bat now is lefty number five, Sam.
Found the zone there. Noah's going to hold on to it. Get it back to the pitcher. Both runners end up advancing.
And that was a double steal. But since the runner stole third, Noah Swango couldn't necessarily throw the runner going to second out, even though he was a little bit later because of the runner on third.
I don't think, quite frankly, anyone was covering at second, or at least covering late.
Right.
So wise of Noah to hold on to it. Again, a smart player, mature player. Look forward to see what he does in his career here in Rochester.
Two balls, two strikes, one out, two runners on. Make that three balls. So the count is full with two runners in scoring position. See if Sam can drive in some runs or what he will do with this next pitch. And ball four, he will walk to load up the bases.
Bases are loaded.
And number nine, Josh, is at the plate for the Fulton Cubs.
As we look at the flag out in center field, a breeze has started to come here. You can feel the cooler air, a little moisture to that air, so I'm guessing it's raining to the west of us here.
Nice shot down the line, just foul.
About a foot foul right there. Really nice down the line to the
very
right
side. Very nice swing to take the outside pitch opposite field. You don't necessarily see that a lot in this league. They just kind of swing. But great job going with the pitch. If you're a Tiger, you just let out a sigh of relief because that could have cleared the bases easily as it runs down the right field line.
Had one to burn there. Takes him to one and two with one out still here in the fourth inning. Dunwoody hanging in there, though. I like to see that. He struggled a little bit. Lost some control, brings it back, can give you two or three good pitches in a row.
Yep.
Had another one to burn. He's okay with two and two. Still ahead on the batter. Oh, excuse me, it's two and one.
That's my fault.
I wasn't going to take responsibility for it. Ball does get by him. Noah played at the plate. And the runner is safe. All runners advance, so we score one. Now there's a runner on third and second. That's going to open up first for the force out.
But great play by Noah. I think he ran back to get it, knew that flipping it to the pitcher might get lost in transition, so he dives himself. He knows he's the catcher. He's got on more heavy gear than the runner coming in, so great job by him to lay out his body and try and dive to save a run. Base open for the Fulton Cubs as the count's 3-1 to Josh.
And over the runner's head, or the batter's head there. It's going to load the bases again with one out here. And we've got a timeout by the coach here. See if he's going to make a change or if he's just going to settle his guy down.
And a change
it will
be.
We do have a change coming, so we're going to be back here in just a few moments. You're watching Rochester Youth League Baseball on RTC TV. And welcome back to Rochester Youth League Baseball on RTC TV. We've had a pitching change here. Rensberger, I believe, is now on the mound, Abby.
You are correct. Tough position for this guy. Bases loaded, one out, and down by quite a few runs. He's just got to throw a strike and hope the Tigers can play some defense for him.
Like to see a double play out of this.
That would be. That's a huge momentum swing for the Tigers.
Coming in, it was across the plate, a little high. Going to be 0-1 or 1-0 on the batter, excuse me. I know Rochester Youth League Baseball would like us to thank all the sponsors who give so generously each and every year to help these kids put together their uniforms and their teams, helps get the fields maintained. You got to play here at the plate. Ball does get away. Ball gets away again. Runner scores.
Curtis will score from third, bringing Sam to replace him at third. Josh at second. First base is open while left-handed number three, Zach, is at the plate for the Fulton Cubs.
We want to, again, acknowledge all the sponsors and thank them for all that they do. You see some of the billboards, the signs out here, some of the team names. Make sure that you shop locally and support these folks, both in Rochester and Fulton, who are giving back to this community every day.
And pitch outside is ball three to the batter.
Yeah, Rensberger having a little difficulty settling down in there, but
again, and two, that's tough, you know, coming off second base, fourth inning of the game, and having to throw. But yeah.
Good kid. I worked with him soccer when I was coaching youth league soccer. I've coached youth league football and soccer, did baseball for 1 year. Rensburger's a good kid.
Seems to me all these athletes are multiple sport athletes. Which
anymore
is great.
They are, which is great. Keeping them fit all year round. Good local sports here in Rochester and Fulton County. He's got to settle down a little bit, get it across the plate, let his teammates make some plays.
Bases loaded with the last batter, Jesse, up to bat for the Fulton County Cubs. Nice pitch, nice swing, but a miss will even the count at one.
I want to take a moment to thank our crew here with RTC TV. Cameraman, summer intern Brant Etchison, as well as Alec Garrick. We've got David Phillips helping with our texts on screen tonight. And as always, you've got your director, Chris Messersmith, helping out with the multiple camera views. Abby Malko, Scott Seger, we're here at Rochester Youth League Field.
Thrown at the head of Jesse, ducks out of the way.
Yeah, that was one of those that even when he ducked, I thought he was still going to get hit.
Yes.
Got 2-1 the count with one out here in the fourth inning.
Nice pitch, could have been a strike, is called for ball four. And that will make the 14th run come across the plate for Fulton. All the runners will advance.
Yeah, and we've seen some of these this year, Abby, where the kids are getting down 10, 12 runs. There are, of course, 10-run rules in each league. But I think for coaches, this is the most important time for you to settle your kids down, let them know that we're going to have days like this. Anything's possible in any sport. We've seen it a million times. We've seen a couple of games this year that just went back and forth, inning after inning. Lots of runs being scored. So, you know, keep the kids calmed down. Make sure they're paying attention, keeping their heads in the game, not playing with the dandelions or building the sandcastles, as you said.
Right. And
focused on baseball, focused on learning.
Absolutely agree.
You know, a team can lose every game out of a season.
And that ball is fair down the right field line. We'll push one across. The second one walks in easily.
That was a great shot down the line. Runner stays at first because of location of the play. Ball was always right in front of him. Couldn't get around to second base, but a really nice shot just staying fair. Clears two bases. Now we've got runners on the corners here.
This brings Wyatt up to the plate. And that's a tough play to field as well. On the corner, there's a base, there's a runner. But definitely a great hit and great placement.
Well, I think if Abby Malko would have been down there, she would have made the play, but she would have sacrificed the body for that one.
It depends. Nice pitch. And the runner will advance.
Forgot to mention cameraman Quentin Sager helping us out tonight as well on the crew. We appreciate all of his help.
Nice hit up the middle. Shortstop playing right up the middle. He will keep the runners on first and second, but not at third.
Yeah, that ball came off the grass, hit the dirt, skipped right up his body, kept it in front of him for the most part, stopped the runner from second advancing, but still allowed the run to come through.
And what's so different, too, you know, having the grass infield right to dirt, that's a different hop of the ball, and the boys have to learn how to play with that, whereas girls softball, we just have straight gravel on the infield. Swing and a miss for strike one. This brings Mike up to the plate, and Mike, this will be his second at-bat of the fourth inning.
Yeah, I don't know about gravel here at Rochester Youth League Field, but I can tell you about brick dust. We used to have that in a town I lived in.
Yes.
In our softball leagues there, and I probably still have some embedded in my skin from a slider, too.
And great hit to the outfield. It will drop in front of the left fielder, scoring the runner from second base as he easily walks across home plate.
Really a nice shot over the third baseman's head, down the line so the left fielder couldn't get to it.
So that will put Wyatt at second base. Mike is on first base, and Caleb is up to bat.
Ball one on the batter. It's going to be one out still.
Caleb started the game pitching and is now catching. And speaking of brick dust, not only is it probably still embedded in your skin, but your socks are probably still the color of brick dust.
We had to throw those out after every game.
Yes, we had. We have brick dust on our practice field at Indiana State, so I know all about that.
Yeah.
Runners advance on a pass ball to second and third bases, leaving first base open for Caleb, who is at the plate.
I will say the brick dust did cut down on a lot of those hops.
Yes. A lot softer than limestone. You see a lot of the college teams now have that surface instead of limestone, which we have here at Rochester, even at Rochester High School for the softball team.
Three and one is the count. I'll help Abby with the scoreboard. She's dazing off here. She's coming down from her sugar high. It's now a sugar coma. So she gets quiet, folks. We know why. That ball was inside, a little high as well. That's going to advance the runner. And again, we have bases loaded here at Rochester Youth League Field. The Rochester Youth League Tigers taking on the Fulton Cubs.
And still one out for the Fulton Cubs. Excuse me, Fulton Tigers on defense.
Way outside. Swango lets it bounce off the backstop back to him. Keeps the runner from advancing.
And I do not think that the Rochester Youth League baseball team has an inning run rule like the Rochester Girls Softball League. This has been 9 runs this inning. Bases loaded, one out, Rochester Tigers in the field, Fulton Cubs at the plate. And nice pitch, a little high to make the count even at one. And strike two on the batter, which is number 7, Brock, for the Fulton Cubs.
Evens up the count, 2-2. Tigers trying to get out of another long inning here.
And strike three, called strike for out number 2.
Rensburger hoping, praying that that was the third out, but it was only 2.
The second out.
Some good pitches there, though, warmed up his arm, came in, of course, cold, and warmed up his arm a little bit. Let's see what he can do with this next batter. Who we got here, Abby?
This is number 2, Luke. Nice pitch from up in the press box. Looks pretty nice.
Strike on the inside corner there.
Did he say strike or did he say too high?
I don't know.
Guess we'll see in a minute. Foul ball. We'll make the count either 1-1 or 0-2. We'll find out in a minute.
What's the count, Marty? Count?
0-2. You are correct.
You should have learned that by now.
I know. And high pop to the second baseman. Catches it for out number 3. Tigers surely relieved to get out of that inning.
And we like to see that. That's some offense. That's some defense. That's everybody having a good time. That's going to do it for the fourth inning here. Rochester Youth League Field. I'm Scott Seger with Abby Malko. We're back here at Rochester Youth League Field, RTC TV. Been joined up in the booth by Eric Lee, local celebrity. Tune in to Eric.
Local celebrity, national.
Wednesday
celebrity.
Mornings at 7:45 for From the Bench. His sports take.
So this inning, we just had a chat with the coaches and the umpires. If the Tigers do not score at least 9 runs in the bottom of this inning, then the game will be over. Right now up to bat is number 11, Yarber.
We used to call them mercy rules. Now they're the 10-run rule after 2 innings or 7 innings. They've all got their own. But, when you're down 18-0, you don't want to demoralize the kids too much. But I do want to point out it was just 2 innings, really, that we saw the bats really working for the Fulton Cubs. And let's see if the Tigers can't put something together here with this inning with Yarber up to bat.
Well, and, too, with baseball and softball, different sports, it's not like basketball where you can – hold out the ball and delay the game and make it slower because you're not trying to score. You really can't do much to delay the game or not score runs in baseball and softball.
Good shot on the outside corner of the plate there. Yarber chased it. Good cut. Couldn't connect.
Makes the count 2-2. He's a number 3 batter for the Tigers. He had a walk this game, and this is his second at-bat. And swing and a miss.
Swing and a miss.
Makes that strike 3 for the first out of the inning. Tigers not well on their way to scoring their 9 runs. We'll see what number 7, Jackson, can do. And Brock still throwing for the Fulton Cubs while Caleb behind the plate. This brings up Jackson, Dalton Jackson, to the plate for the Rochester Tigers. And good foul ball, evens the count at 1.
Ball outside, takes the count to 2-1 with 1 out here in the bottom of the 4th inning. You're watching RTC TV. Today we're at Rochester Youth League Field. Scott Sager here with Abby Malco.
Ball on the outside corner for the 3rd ball.
Oh, a bad pitch to swing at. He knows it.
Makes the count full. Would have been ball 4, first runner on the base this inning for the Tigers. We'll see if Dalton Jackson can battle his way out of this.
It just shows you, Abby, you know, with 3 or 4 players out of your starting rotation, that changes the dynamic of the game completely.
Absolutely.
Younger players get a chance to experience a little bit more playing time.
Dalton Jackson will take first base on the walk.
It's going to put our first runner on.
And this brings latest pitcher, Rensberger, to the plate.
Long way to go to get the W for Rensberger, so let's see if he can help himself out here.
One pitch at a time, they
ball
say.
Ball gets away from the catcher there. Runner advances to second base.
Jackson on second, Rensberger at the plate with 1 out. Nice fly ball to shallow center field. It will drop in front of the center fielder, but because it was a high pop fly, Jackson had to stay on second base. Puts Rensberger at first, bringing up the catcher, Josh Swango, to the plate.
This is the best opportunity they've got. One in scoring position. Another guy on first base.
One pass ball could move them both into scoring position.
Absolutely.
And a hit could put 2 across. Josh Swango, one other at-bat this game, had a strikeout. See if he can change his luck this at-bat. Nice swing and a miss by Josh Swango to make the count 1-1. Ball on the outside corner makes the count 2-1. The pitcher for Fulton, Brock, studies a lot before the pitch, trying to get his signals from his catcher, but definitely slowing down the inning.
And that one's outside again. Catcher has to chase it. Both runners advance. You now have two in scoring position here.
Like we said, one pass ball puts them both in scoring position, and one hit will put them both across the plate.
Absolutely. We got a chance for bases loaded here for the Tigers. With three balls and one strike, the batter can let this one sail by, make the pitcher earn it. He does, in fact, walk. That's going to load the bases for the first time today for the Rochester Tigers.
This brings up number 15, Schaefer.
Eric Lee, ladies and gentlemen, legend here in Rochester, leaving the building. If I could get a camera on you, Eric, we'd showcase you. Thanks for being here.
Ball one to Schaefer. Bases loaded. One out. Tigers may be ready to rally. So before they do so, the Fulton Cubs coach is going to come out to the mound and have a chat with his pitcher.
See if he's going to settle him down or if he's going to pull him out. Had a pretty good run. What's this, his second inning here? They're starting to catch up with him, though, in this inning. And
last inning, yeah, he did well. He was three up, three down. I think the pitcher talking, or the coach talking to the pitcher about release points, and he's been throwing balls a little too high. Now with the bases loaded, a little more threatening situation. See if he can find the zone here.
He's going to leave him in. We resume play.
And swing and a miss by Schaefer evens the count at one.
Kind of just chase one up high.
And thrown behind the batter for ball number two.
Seen a lot more of that than I remember when I was young.
Yes, I think so.
That's what happens when you try and aim it and the arm just doesn't go. You're trying to overcorrect.
That's correct.
There
and
we go.
Nice hit to shallow right field. We'll put one across for the Tigers. The second run is threatening. A throw on the run by the second baseman bounces perfectly into home plate. And that's something you don't see very often, a pretty athletic throw by the second baseman. That will put the Tigers on the board for the first time this game. The score is now 18-1, bringing up Manns to the plate.
Manns shows up to the plate. He's ready to go. The umpire's not even ready, but Manns is here. He's ready to go. In the box. Cock back, ready to go. We got Jordan Schaefer on first base. We got runners on second and third as well.
Rensberger on third, Swango on second, and Schaefer at first. And I'm not sure if that was a swing or a duck, but either way, the umpire called it a strike.
I think that was a, I'm going to hit this, no, I'm going to get out of the way, and bat just kind of goes where it needs to.
I agree.
I like that.
Pass ball will still hold the runner at third, but he thought about scoring. Evens the count at ones.
Well, we're glad to see the smiles out here on the kids' faces. They're having a lot of fun. Third baseman playing in, really. All the
yes.
way to the grass on this.
Actually, the entire infield, now that you say that, is playing in, trying to get the run at home, which I guess it's the coach's philosophy. But if you're up by 17 runs, you'd think you just want to try and get the outs. But if they're trying to get the outs at home, Either way works.
Works both ways. When you're down 17, you might as well let it fly and let the kids see some new plays. Now, what you don't want to do here is walk the runner.
Right.
Or the batter, excuse me.
Three and one to Manns at the plate. Ball high, two walk and a run. That puts Tigers on the board for the second consecutive run this game.
Won't call it a rally quite yet, but good job getting a couple of runs across here. Still got some opportunities, only down one run, or excuse me, only with one out. Long way to go, though. Let's take a look.
And big swing and a miss by number nine. That is strike number one. Ball on the outside corner evens the count at one. And hard to be an aggressive base runner in this situation with the bases loaded. You don't want to overrun the runner in front of you. And it's actually a rule I did not know till this year that if someone hits a home run, not a home run, excuse me, if someone hits a fly ball to the outfield, and let's say the bases are loaded and number nine hits a fly ball and all the runners tag, if he were to overrun the person on first base, they both would be out.
Yeah, we hope that doesn't happen.
Right. Just got to be aware of your runners and not overrun each other to have an out that's not needed.
Nice pitch down the middle.
Pop fly to the
infield
second baseman.
Fly rule is called.
And I think he was trying to keep it exciting for the crowd. A pop fly right above his head. He backpedaled, almost caught it behind his back, but nonetheless made the catch for the second out of the inning. Leadoff batter up at the plate, Dunwoody. Andrew Dunwoody, his third at-bat of the game. He's a leadoff batter.
Really liked what we saw out of him from the mound tonight. Got lit up a couple of times, but really a consistent player. Could find that strike zone, stay with that strike zone.
Yes, a good little pitcher now, and exciting to see what his future holds.
Absolutely, and that's what it's all about here, is the future. These kids could lose every game. But if they take home a sectional title or a national championship, that's what it's all for.
And that will be the third out. Could have tagged third base, ended up tagging the runner. And that is the third out of the inning for the Tigers. Want to make sure they're lining up before we call the game this time.
Abby with the tendency to call the games a little early.
But, hey, I think we are. The bats are down. The gloves are off. We are lining up to shake hands across the field.
Great job by both teams tonight. Again, the Fulton Cubs defeating the Rochester Major League.
Tigers.
By a score of a lot to a little.
Yes.
A lot was learned here tonight. They had a lot of fun. They're shaking hands. Thanks for joining me. I'm Scott Sager. This is Abby Malco with us. Thanks to Chris Messersmith, David Phillips, and all the gang here who helped us put this on. You're watching Rochester Youth League Baseball on RTC TV.